"Who is this?" asked the Wizard, curiously. The Prince had been staring hard at the girl on the bush. Now he answered with a touch of uneasiness in his cold tones. "She is the ruler destined to be my successor, for she is a royal princess. When she becomes fully ripe, I must abandon the sovereignty of the Mangaboos to her."
"Isn't she ripe now?" asked Dorothy. He hesitated.
"Not quite," said he finally. "It will be several days before she needs to be picked, or at least that is my judgment. I am in no hurry to resign my office and be planted, you may be sure."
"Probably not," declared the Wizard, nodding.
"This is one of the most unpleasant things about our vegetable lives," continued the Prince with a sigh, "that while we are in our full prime, we must give way to another and be covered up in the ground to sprout and grow and give birth to other people."
"I'm sure the Princess is ready to be picked," asserted Dorothy, gazing hard at the beautiful girl on the bush. "She's as perfect as she can be."
"Never mind," answered the Prince hastily. "She will be all right for a few days longer, and it's best for me to rule until I can dispose of you strangers, who have come to our land uninvited and must be attended to at once."
"What are you going to do with us?" asked Zeb.
"That is a matter I have not quite decided upon," was the reply. "I think I shall keep this wizard until a new sorcerer is ready to pick, for he seems quite skillful and may be of use to us. But the rest of you must be destroyed in some way, and you cannot be planted, because I do not wish horses and cats and meat people growing all over our country."
"You needn't worry," said Dorothy. "We wouldn't grow underground, I'm sure."